Just before we get started, I'd like to say that this video is made possible by the free-to-play action game Crossout. Check out the game through the link in the description below, and you can start with 3 extra weapons or a vehicle cabin just for registering. The history of civilization is replete with examples of humanity improving the world in which it lives. Through ingenuity, imagination, and hard work, humanity spanned rivers, built roads, erected cities, and created the infrastructure to connect them all. Some projects took centuries to complete, others were finished with alacrity driven by immediate needs. Many were treated with derision by contemporaries who considered the vision of their proponents to be delusional. Some, the Panama Canal being one example of many, were completed only after a spectacular and expensive failure during earlier attempts. Still others were spurred by the competition between nations and empires. Spectacular feats of engineering even preceded the term engineer. The Great Wall of China, the pyramids of the Mayan and Aztec cultures, the cities of the ancient world, all were accomplished by engineering, though the builders and designers were unaware that they were engineers. Over the centuries, engineering accomplishments were directed to the worship of gods and heroes, the improvement of society and life, and to simply celebrate the spirit of humanity. In the video today, we're looking at 10 of the greatest engineering accomplishments through all of history. Number 10. The Roman Water Distribution System. 3 centuries before the beginning of the Common Era, the Roman Republic, later the Roman Empire, distributed water throughout its dominions using a system of canals, pipes, reservoirs, standing tanks, and aqueducts. Entirely through the use of gravity, the Romans distributed fresh water to cities and towns, as well as to mines and to farms. Some of these aqueducts, they still stand today, architectural marvels built by laborers under the supervision of surveyors and master builders. By the end of the 3rd century, the city of Rome was serviced by 11 separate water conduits distributing water throughout the city, and in the case of the wealthier citizens, directly into their homes. Poorer residents, they had to resort to public wells and baths. The empire was serviced with water systems as well, operated by both local governments and the state. Natural springs were the preferred source of water. Easements were established by law on either side of the conduit's pathway. The waterways were liberally supplied with inspection points, which would today be called manholes, and the water was routinely inspected for purity. Lead piping was used in some sections, though the use of ceramic piping was preferred. Further, sections of the aqueducts, which were made of concrete, were lined with brick to prevent erosion and help filter the water. The system was so well designed and so well built that there are sections that are still in use for the distribution of fresh water nearly 20 centuries after they were built. Number 9. The Cathedral of Hagia Sophia. Built as a Christian church and later converted to an Islamic mosque, the Cathedral of Hagia Sophia is today a museum and an iconic image of Turkey. Originally constructed in the 6th century, it has survived rioting, looting by conquerors, earthquakes, fire, and the ravages of time. Built chiefly of masonry, it's easily recognized by its corner minarets and its massive dome. Built and rebuilt many times over the years, it remains a symbol of Byzantine architecture, and for over 1,000 years, Hagia Sophia was the largest cathedral in the world. Its design, it was revolutionary for its day. The huge dome is set upon a square base, supported by 4 triangle-shaped pendentives in the square's corners. The pendentives carry the weight of the dome and direct it downwards rather than outwards, as the shape of the dome would otherwise dictate. Though the dome has collapsed on more than one occasion and was modified during rebuilding to include ribs which help distribute its weight onto the supporting walls, each rebuilding strengthened it and improved the overall structure of the building. Hagia Sophia is a museum of both the Christian and Islamic faiths, as well as the Byzantine Empire and the Crusades. It remains one of the largest masonry buildings in the world in the 21st century. Number 8. The Leshan Buddha. Carved from a single stone and completed in the early 9th century, the Great Buddha of Leshan stands at over 230 feet tall, with a breadth across the shoulders of 92 feet. It is the tallest statue of Buddha to be found in the world, carved from the sandstone of a cliff overlooking the junction of Min and Dari rivers in Sichuan. Ordinarily, sandstone would be easily eroded by the rainwater which has fallen on the statue over the centuries. However, ingenious engineering controls the flow of water through and behind the statue, which has served to protect it since its completion in 803 CE. The Leshan Buddha includes over 1,000 coiled hair buns of stone which are placed on the statue's head. They were designed to collect rainwater and route it into a system of drains and drain pipes which allow the water to flow through the statue's head and arms, draining out the back behind the stone clothes and away from the statue, protecting it from the effects of erosion. This system was all installed as part of the original carving. Originally protected by a wooden shelter which was destroyed by the Mongols, the statue has stood exposed to the elements for 7 centuries, with its drainage system protected protecting it from erosion. Today, the greatest threat to the statue is the heavily polluted air of the region, a factor its designers certainly didn't anticipate. Number 7. The Erie Canal. Between the Hudson River and Lake Erie, land elevation increases by about 600 feet. Canal locks of the day, 1800, could raise or lower boats about 12 feet, which meant that at least 50 locks would be required to build a canal which linked the Hudson River with the Great Lakes. President Thomas Jefferson called the project little short of madness. New York's governor, Dewitt Clinton, disagreed, and he supported the project, which led to its detractors calling the canal DeWitt's Ditch. Clinton pursued the project fervently, overseeing the creation of a 360-mile-long waterway across upstate New York, which linked the upper Midwest to New York City. The cities of Buffalo, New York, and Cleveland, Ohio thrived once the canal was completed in 1825. The engineering demands of the canal included the removal of earth using animal power, water power using aqueducts to redirect water flow, and gunpowder in order to blast through limestone. None of the canal's planners and builders were professional engineers. Instead, they were mathematics instructors, judges, and amateur surveyors who learned as they went. Labor was provided by increased immigration, mostly from Ireland and Germany. When it was completed in 1825, the canal was considered an engineering masterpiece, one of the longest canals in the world. The Erie Canal's heyday was relatively short, though, due to the development of the railroads. However, it did lead to the growth of the Port of New York and spurred the building of competing canals in other eastern states. Number 6. The Brooklyn Bridge. The Brooklyn Bridge was originally envisioned by John Rubling, who had built suspension bridges of shorter spans across the Ohio River and at other locations. The engineering project, located in Brooklyn and Manhattan, led to an accident which cost Rubling his life, and the engineering challenges they were passed on to his son, Washington Rubling. Washington was stricken with the bends early in the construction and was forced to supervise the project from his Manhattan apartment. The engineering challenges were difficult. Wooden caissons were sunk to the bottom of the East River, with men inside them to excavate the river bottom until the caissons reached bedrock. In the case of the East Tower supporting the bridge, they never did. The tower rests on sand this very day. It took 14 years to complete the project, from 1869 to 1883. Often described as a suspension bridge, their structure is in reality a hybrid suspension and cable stayed bridge, with the load of the span being transferred by wire cables to the towers and thence to the bedrock on the Brooklyn side and the sand over the bedrock on the Manhattan side. In the 21st century, it carries 6 lanes of traffic as well as bicycles and pedestrians, though it no longer accommodates rail traffic nor commercial vehicles. It was considered the engineering masterpiece of the world at the time of its completion, spanning nearly 6,000 feet and linking the formerly separate cities of Brooklyn and New York. So, maybe you've been watching this video and thinking, boy, making things sounds like fun, I bet I could do that. Well, hey, in that case, you should definitely download Crossout. And that's something I want to tell you about before we get into today's top 5. Crossout is an online vehicle action game where all of the vehicles are made by the players. Basically, what you do is you construct your own crazy vehicle from the ground up with all sorts of different parts thrown together. You can add weapons, support systems, the main structure, a whole bunch else to your vehicle, from railguns to rocket boosters. Basically, you can create your own incredible engineering accomplishments and then use it to destroy other people's incredible engineering accomplishments. It's a super fast-paced game with lots of different modes, and you've got pretty much limitless freedom to create, and what you do with your vehicle is entirely up to you. It's also not complicated at the start, with it being a very easy learning curve, allowing you to make your own vehicle and get into the game super quickly. Loads of different game modes as well, so you're sure to find one that you love. So join us on the battlefield for free, by the way, using the link in the description below. Works on PC, Xbox One, PS4, all very easy. And going through that link not only helps support this show, but you'll also get a free starter set with 3 extra weapons or a vehicle cabin, all as just a bonus for registering. Thanks to Crossout for sponsoring, and let's get into the top 5, shall we? Number 5. The Eiffel Tower. Gustave Eiffel built the iconic symbol of Paris, indeed of all of France, to serve as the gateway to the 1889 World's Fair. Contrary to popular belief, Eiffel did not design the tower. Instead, he purchased the patent rights to the design from engineers within his employ. He then signed a contract for the construction of the tower, acting as himself rather than as his company, and later set up another company to handle the management of the tower and the income derived from it. The design of the tower was controversial from the outset, with artists and engineers complaining of its lack of aesthetic value. It was said that the French writer Guy de Maupassant ate at the restaurant in the tower after its completion because it was the only place in Paris from which the tower could not be seen. The ironwork was delivered to the site with holes for connecting bolts pre-drilled, and as they were installed, the tower was brought into proper alignment through the use of hydraulic jacks installed near the structure. Creeper cranes climbed the legs of the tower to erect each succeeding level. The tower was declared complete in March of 1889. At the time, it was the tallest man-made structure in the world. It reached a height of 1,063 feet and remains the tallest structure in Paris to this day. The tower was supposed to be dismantled in 1909 under the terms of the original contract, but its usefulness as a radio transmitter gained it a longer lease on life. By the end of the 20th century, the idea of dismantling the tower was simply unthinkable. Number 4. The Panama Canal. The 51-mile-long cut across the Isthmus of Panama was a dream for many decades prior to the French beginning its construction in 1881. During the building of America's transcontinental railroad, equipment for use in the Sierras was shipped from the east coast of the United States to Panama, transferred across the Isthmus, and then shipped to California. Engineers for years studied the building of the canal before the French attempted to complete one, but the engineering difficulties combined with the climate and politics thwarted their efforts for more than two decades. The United States stepped in where the French failed and completed the canal in 1914 after another 10 years of work. The canal is actually two canals connected on either end by an artificial lake. Locks on the two canals raise or lower ships to or from the level of the lake, allowing them to traverse from Atlantic to Pacific or vice versa. The canal allows ships to transfer from one ocean to the other in just under 12 hours. It was the decision to abandon the sea level canal and instead use a lake and locks that allowed the Americans to complete the project. Number 3. The Channel Tunnel. For centuries, the British Isles remained unconnected to the European continent, a situation which many Britons favored as critical to their national security. Numerous proposals for a tunnel beneath the Channel were put forth, but opposition within England and France prevented any serious efforts. Attempts to build tunnels for automobile traffic were started and stopped in the mid to late 20th century. Finally, in the late 1980s, after the usual political maneuvering among governments, businesses, and financiers, work on the tunnels for high-speed rail trains got underway. Very early on, the Channel Tunnel was given its nickname of the Channel. The tunnel was built from both sides, using massive tunnel boring machines which would approach each other and meet in the middle. The machines bored through what was mostly chalk, though the varying geology of the French shore created some difficulties. Both the French and the English used the removed soil for land reclamation projects. The tunnels were lined with both cast iron and reinforced concrete. When completed, the tunnel provided electrical power to the trains running through it via overhead lines. The tunnel opened in 1994 and today allows for a trip from London to Paris in just over 2 hours. The tunnel also allows for freight traffic delivering goods from Europe to Britain and vice versa. Number 2. The Burj Khalifa. The world's tallest structure as of 2019, the Burj Khalifa is a mixed-use skyscraper in Dubai, which was completed in 2009. The building was designed by the same Chicago firm which designed the Willis Tower, formerly the Sears Tower in that city, and uses the same engineering principle of bundled tubes at its core to support the building's weight. The tubular design allowed for substantially less steel to be used in construction, with most of the building being reinforced concrete. Its spire alone, which is mostly decorative, would qualify it as the 11th tallest structure in Europe if it were erected on that continent. For those of a hardy constitution, the 2,909 steps connect the ground floor with the 160th. The observation deck is located on the 124th floor. The surrounding park, known as Burj Khalifa Park, is landscaped with desert plants, which are kept hydrated using water collected by the building's cooling system, which itself relies on the cooler air of the upper portion of the building to decrease the temperatures of the lower portion of the structure. Number 1. The Apollo Space Program. It remains one of the signature engineering achievements in the history of the human race. No other program has delivered human beings to an environment other than their home planet and returned them safely to Earth. Americans not only walked on the surface of the moon, they drove on it using a battery-driven vehicle designed for the purpose, capable of carrying two astronauts and greatly increasing the area which lunar explorers could cover. It was carried to the moon with the Lunar Excursion Module, LEM, and used for the final three moon missions in the early 1970s. In 2003, the National Academy of Engineers called the program the greatest engineering team effort in American history. The Apollo program has led to significant advances in the development of integrated circuitry, contributed to the growing cause of environmentalism, and over 20% of the world's population watched on television when astronaut Neil Armstrong left the first human footprints on the lunar surface. NASA had spin-offs from the space program in the areas of freeze-dried food, emergency reflective blankets, handheld portable vacuum cleaners, and more than 2,000 other areas. LASIK surgery is also a direct descendant of the technology developed to dock with vehicles in space, first performed as part of the Gemini program, in which astronauts learned the techniques required for Apollo. So I really hope you found that video interesting and inspiring. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and do not forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. If you're looking for more from me, why not click on a video from the archives on the screen or check out my other channel called Today I Found Out. There'll be a link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.